April 29th, 2015 Zoning Board of Appeals meeting. Could we have a roll call, please?
Crockett?
Here.
Stark?
Here.
Boisel?
Here.
Maroon?
Here.
Richard?
Here.
Stanhope? Mississo?
Okay, very good. We'll stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay, a couple of notes just before we start. One is appeal number 2537 has been withdrawn. Our understanding is that they are actually able to sell the property as is, which is great. And appeal number 2543 is tabled per Mr. Jim
Fisher.
I just met him out in the hallway, and he wanted to table to the following meeting. So we'll put him next on the agenda, at first on the agenda next month, I think he'd be second on the agenda next month, if they so choose. So, could I have a motion on the minutes of the March 11th, 2015 meeting, please?
Motion to approve.
Any discussion? All in favor? Opposed? None? Thank you very much. So we'll jump into the single appeal tonight. Who's taking that? Was it Mr. Richard?
Okay, thank you.
Appeal number 2538 is a practical difficulty of variance by Kevin Coyne, 60 Ocean Avenue, Assessor's Map, U2, Parcel 181. Welcome, Mr. Coyne.
Thank you.
If you could just state your name and address again for the record, that would be great.
My name's Kevin Coyne, 60 Ocean Avenue, Scarborough.
Thank you. And if you'd like to describe what we're up to, what's going on, we'll go from there.
Yes, since the last meeting, I submitted updated drawings for the site plan and a front elevation that included moving the garage into the main structure and giving more detail on setbacks from the property. So the setbacks include the soffits, which were not included in the initial meters.
So just from a reference point of view, we've been here before, looked at a couple of different options. Mr. Coyne's gone back and worked with the architectural firm and laid out a different plan. And then the first time it was the garage was off the property.
That's correct. It was a separate garage.
And the second time we tabled because of... I'm trying to know what the reason was.
There were some discrepancies in the distances given, I believe.
I think that's right.
Yeah, the soffits weren't included in the setback request.
Yeah.
So this is the third version of we've discussed, which is good. And thank you for the thorough plans. It makes it a lot easier for us to work with. And I know it's a difficult process, but thank you for being so thorough. So if you'd like to just explain what's going on different than what we talked about, and we'll go from there.
Okay. On the site plan, the property, the structure, the front of it's been even straight across to include the garage. So in 4 feet was added to the south side, going from the front of the structure back 20 feet.
Go ahead, yeah.
And more detail on the drawing was included for the soffit overhangs with dimensions. In addition, there's a cover sheet for this that lists the detailed dimensions and the setbacks for the front and the side.
Back. Okay. Anything you'd also like to add, or is that good for now?
There's no modifications needed to that.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Mr. Lundstedt, anything you want to add to this? Or?
No, I just point out that I do have a site plan up on the big screen that it's easy for folks to look at, and it indicates just exactly what Mr. Coyne has told you. He's dimensioned to the overhangs this time. The table that he's provided outlines all of his lot areas as well, and we found that he was just slightly under on the lot coverage, building coverage, so that's good. I also can show you his floor plan and elevations. That's what the building is going to look like. And the floor plan that he's provided is there. So he's integrated the garage into the structure instead of having it as a detached garage, which the board seemed to indicate that it would favor more than having that separate larger garage area. So he's really reduced his footprint, I think, on the lot. And I think he's also provided all of the additional information and the corrected information that the board's asked for. Everything else
looks good.
Standing is the same.
The section we're looking at is for the requirement is whether or not the property is zoned as significant economic injury and unable to use the property as light. And you've taken, again, if you could walk us through the reasons why you felt this needed. We've already done this twice before, so I don't want to bludgeon you to death on it.
Yeah.
But just, I'd like to tie it up. I think you've done a great job with this personally.
Thank you.
And if the board has any objections, I think this is fairly straightforward. There are some requirements, but they're pretty straightforward.
And if you look at the main structure, it was built maybe in the early 1900s, and it was built on the ground. Most places at the beach were built on cedar posts. So it's actually rotting from the ground up. I've had to do repairs over the years. And it's 2x4 construction. It's old technology construction. It's not insulated very well. And it's become my main primary residence. So I've also looked at lifting the structure, but structurally it's not strong enough to be lifted, or if it did, economically it wouldn't be worth it. The town assessed the building structure at $19,000. I think to lift it would be like $10,000, so why would you spend 50% of your structure's value on lifting something that's bad to begin with? So I'd like to start with a clean slate, put a proper foundation under it, and build a two-code, two-and-a-half-story structure.
Very good. Thank you. Is there open the public hearing? Do you have any letters on this at all?
No.
None. Open the public hearing. There's nobody here to speak to it, so I'll close the public hearing. Mr. Longstaff, anything that you see that concerns you at all on this? Or?
No, I think it's gotten a very thorough going over from the board in the previous two hearings. And in my estimation, I think Mr. Coyne has provided the board with all of the information it's asked for. So it basically comes down to addressing the criteria and determining whether or not the findings of fact can support conclusions of law in order to either grant or deny the appeal.
Very good. Can I borrow your section of your book on that? Sure. I always have everything from a different location today. I'm a parent of a two-year-old right now. It's changed my world. So it's on page 30, and what we'll go through is the requirements of the practical difficulty variance. And I'd like to go through line by line. If each member of the board could state their positions on any issues they have or ask any questions, we'll go from there, all right? The needs of the variance is due to the unique circumstance of the property and not to the general conditions of the neighborhood. And Mr. Coyne, if you just want to reiterate what you had said in the previous meetings about that issue, I'll read it again. The need for the variance is due to the unique circumstances of the property and not to the general conditions in the neighborhood. You've already said it twice before, but again, to close this door, if you could repeat that again for us, that'd be great.
Yeah, it's an aged structure, and it really doesn't match the other houses in the area. They're all built in the 1990s or maybe the 70s, and they all have foundations. So I think it would be better for the neighborhood, and it's really a dated structure. So.
Thank you. The next is the granting of the variance will not produce an unreasonable change in the character of the neighborhood and will not have an unreasonably detrimental effect on either the use or the fair market value of the abutting properties.
Oh, yes. It would definitely improve what my neighbors look out their window and see. I mean, their houses are really nice, and I call mine the shack among houses. It's really, an old structure and needs to be torn down. So I'm certain my neighbors would like to see it replaced. So.
Practical difficulty is not a result of action taken by the applicant or prior owner. It's just because it's been there forever.
Yeah, it's
it's an older property.
It's an older property. It was built before the setbacks were in place, right? So.
Okay. No other feasible alternative is available to the applicant except the variance. That would be correct because of the requirements of the code, but also we've torn this thing apart quite a bit. So I think we've looked at all other feasible alternatives down to whether or not this meets it or not. The granting of variance will result in bringing the applicant's property more nearly into conformance with surrounding properties. Go ahead.
Yes. It'll be a house on a foundation versus a house on the ground, and there'll be the ceilings inside are like 6.5, less than 7 feet. Inside and out, it'll be a more modern structure.
What's the problem with 6.5 feet ceilings?
I'm vertically challenged, too. So it's,
At 5'6", it doesn't bother me at all. The granting of variance will not be unreasonable. So we said that. You're not located in whole or in part in a shoreline zone, so we're not worried about that. And who's doing the construction for you on the project? Have you decided yet? Or?
No, I'm going to go up to bid for
it. Okay, but you're going to be using all the proper procedures of that. We'll be
kind of working with the town code enforcement and building inspectors.
Board members, questions, comments?
No, I think he's done a nice job, the chairman. I think he's come back and shrunk the structure, and I think he's met all the criteria, clearly met all the criteria.
I have to be candid with you. I didn't think you'd be able to do it. At the last meeting, I didn't know whether or not I could comfortably approve it. I think you've done number one, I think there's a great lesson for anybody that comes here. It's hard work to come here. You did a fantastic job with the work you did. You were willing to work with us, and in my opinion, I think I just did a fantastic job. I have no questions, no comments, other than to say I support it.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, I think that you certainly have done your due diligence on this thing, and you've responded to the questions and given the answers that we've needed to be able to give you any kind of an approval on this. So we thank you for that.
I think the only thing I'd add to that is the hardest question that we have typically in this type of an appeal is question number 4, with no feasible alternatives, and doing your due diligence makes that answer easy. It's easy to say yes to that. So, thank you.
So just for the record, these are fairly straightforward. I don't want to make everybody go through these line by line, but on any of these specific items, does anybody have any questions, comments about these items specifically? The needs of the variance is due to the unique circumstances of the property. I think that's a fair statement. If the board agrees with that statement, we'll just say that as a rule. I jump in if you disagree.
Sure.
The granting of the variance will not produce an undesirable change in the character of the neighborhood. It's obvious that it'll only improve the neighborhood. The practical difficulty is not the result of an action taken by the applicant or prior owner. Obviously, this is an older home, and sometimes they just wear out.
Especially when it's built on the ground.
Yeah. As far as number 4, there's no reasonable alternative that's available to the applicant except a variance. Again, I think we can say that we've looked at all other options, and I know that you've spent a lot of time working with Mr. Coyne on this and appreciate it. And I think we've determined that is the only option.
And it's also a good example for other applicants in the future.
It is a great example of other applicants. The granting of variance will result in bringing the applicant's property more nearly into conformance with surrounding properties. That, to me, is a rather odd one.
I think, in this case, if you look at the surrounding properties, they're more into the 20th century than this particular property was. So I think by him bringing it in, it does meet that requirement.
Okay. The granting of the ranch will not have an adverse effect on the natural environment. Obviously, you're going to do the proper procedures for taking care of the environment as a development. That's really where the real issue comes in. As far as this project is concerned, I'm not worried about that with the way the town handles things, and you're not in the shoreland zone. So based on that, I think the findings of fact are pretty straightforward, and I do believe it meets the essence and the meaning and the purpose of the practical difficulty variance to a T at this point. That's all. I have a motion for discussion on prior to motion.
I make a motion to approve.
Sorry.
Second over here. So approved by Mr. Richard.
Second.
Second in. Discussion on the motion. Seeing none, all in favor?
Good.
That's unanimous. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much. Appreciate your time.
Thank you for your help.
Appreciate your help.
Because of the other items being tabled and withdrawn, we are complete with this meeting. So I would ask the board members if they have any comments or questions. I've already told. Anything from you, Ms. Longstaff?
I did have something else. What was it? we are proceeding forward. I talked to Mr. Stark earlier today about this, the initiative to explore form-based codes for the Higgins Beach area to get rid of some of those hard-to-manage setback issues and stuff. I think we started this discussion while he was on hiatus.
Yeah.
So you may not.
My vacation.
Maybe you're just hearing about your vacation.
I know you guys have been working on trying to make it less onerous for.
The town has entered into a relationship with a consultant who is well-versed in form-based codes, has worked in other communities.
What is that called? I'm sorry. Form?
Form-based codes.
Okay.
And.
Could you explain what that means?
I wish I could. Form-based codes don't deal so much with what you can't do, but more with what you can do.
Okay.
So instead of putting up roadblocks, it sets up parameters under which you can do things. Okay. So it kind of approaches it from a different angle. And I'm not going to say any more about it than that because I'd be talking way above my ability to comprehend
Oh, then I'll carry on.
I don't have a definition.
Okay.
I'm not reading from a definition. But suffice to say, it's a proven way to deal with some of these issues where you sort of have a neighborhood character type thing. And it's a way to get that, kind of keep that in be able to develop and move forward in time with new technology and whatnot and structural improvements and so on and so forth without having to deal with these very restrictive, very regimented, prescriptive type codes that I forget the term that the consultants used. Forgive me, it's been a long day. So I'm grasping for it, but I can't think of it. But this is a way to deal with some of the issues that we're facing down in Higgins Beach with the very small lots currently having very large setback issues, trying to squeeze buildings into the middle of the lot when historically they've been to the front of the lot and they've had backyards. And everything that we've done probably in the last 20 years really is counter to the way that Higgins Beach was historically developed. So we're trying to get that back now before we entirely lose it. The consultants that are going to be helping us are going to put on a charrette. I believe it's going to be scheduled for June 5th, 6th, and 7th. The charrette will invite the Higgins Beach neighborhood community, consultants, designers that work in Higgins Beach, contractors that work in Higgins Beach, planning board members, zoning board members, town councils. So it's going to be quite an event to get everything on the table and try to come away with some takeaways that give them the framework to then go ahead and develop this form-based code.
That's fantastic.
It's going to be a really nice effort. It's going to be a lot of work. Once we've had that charrette, we hope that things can move quickly through the process once we are able to develop the code. They've got some templates that we can work from, so we're not exactly starting completely from scratch. There's some templates for these codes, and what we need to do is get input from our community as to what they want those parameters to look like. So one thing we are thinking about, I'll bring it up at the risk of taking a lot of heat from it, but we're actually considering offering out to any future variant appeals appellants that if they would like to withdraw their appeal pending this form-based code process to take its course and see what those outcomes are, we could potentially, and again, this is in discussion phase, it's not official yet, but we might be able to also refund their application fee at that time if they're willing to pull back and also take and participate in the process so that we get their input as well. In other words, in the timeframe between now and when we have an outcome from this, I would hate to see the board in a position where they either have to approve or deny something that might otherwise end up being okay or be able to be done in a better way that meets the character of the neighborhood instead of coming up with some of these weird contraptions that sort of meet the code, but nobody's really happy with it. So we're kind of tossing that about because we really have high hopes for this to solve a lot of problems. Not all the problems, but it'll solve a lot of the problems. Yeah.
Does that also apply? Are they going to look at Pine Point at all?
Not at this point. This is going to be, this first initiative is really going to be Higgins Beach. Higgins Beach has some very unique problems that they have to deal with there that aren't all shared. Not all of those problems are shared in the Pine Point. Pine Point has its own challenges, and Higgins Beach has its own challenge. We'd like to see how this works for Higgins Beach. The process may be the same process. The outcome might be a little different for Pine Point because of those challenges.
Sure.
So we'll eat the elephant one bite at a time and take Higgins Beach first, and then if that works well, we can take a look at Pine Point as well.
And that credit goes to you, Mr. Stark, and this guy over here, right?
Yeah.
You guys have been doing the work.
Mr. Bacon.
Mr. Bacon, Rick. I mean, you can.
Well, everybody has chimed in over the last year or two. We finally woke up and realized we're hearing way too many appeals for things that shouldn't have to come to the board to get approval for. A lot of these things make sense. They just can't meet our ordinance restrictions. That's what we're trying to do.
To me, that speaks volumes. If I remember correctly, I wasn't here. I was already off the board. But I think Mr. Loisel and Mr. Stark and you started that ball conversation going, and Mr. Bacon got involved and whatever. But I think this says a lot about the two previous chairs that did it to bring that forward and for you to work with them. I congratulate you and appreciate that work, and I just want to make sure it's recognized that that's where the input, that's where that energy came from. It wasn't from me.
We should also, thank the fact that you guys all chimed in and supported that, and then it went to the Long Range Planning Committee, and they also supported it. They heard what you had to say, and they supported it. And through all of the various people that touched this thing, I think it's going to be a really, I have very high hopes for it. I think it's going to be very successful. It's going to definitely be an interesting project.
It's good government.
And if we can even make things 50% better down there for people who want to make improvements to their homes by having these form-based codes that better address their needs, I think the building code will address the building code issues. It's the zoning that's preventing them from being able to do what they want. So, I'm real excited about it.
Well, thanks. Any other comments? You can say something nice about me if you'd like. Absolutely, something nice about you.
I would like to suggest that next meeting you put some color in your wardrobe. That'd be nice. Other than that, I have nothing to say.
Other members of the board, any comments?
All set.
So I have a motion to adjourn.
Yes, to adjourn.
All in favor? That's unanimous. Thank you very much. Have a great evening.